There's a launch modal. It points trials and new users to right set of actions. Right now on the screen says, welcome to Photoshop. There's three options, watch new, hands-on tutorials, and quick actions. Can you talk a little bit about this experience here?
Yeah. So firstly, this is an example of how the second part of my team kind of worked with the core product teams to launch a new model. This was originally just a what's new panel that was blanket for everybody just to show what new features are launched in Photoshop. But we decided to repurpose that for new users for onboarding in a different way. And what's new is a small portion of it, but there's hands-on tutorials and quick actions. And this, to your point, Laila, we have been testing different orders as well. And we did actually, we actually went to usertesting.com and we got a bunch of feedback before we actually even launched our very first test. Optimization test, because we wanted to understand from the users what is most useful for them. So for someone new coming in, there's two things that is very easy. Like hands-on tutorials are very quick, 3-minute, you know, tutorials. They're typically under 5 minutes, which is the amount of patience anyone new has. Like they join in, you don't want to be sitting and looking at someone doing something for 20 minutes. So it's really handpicked, like short tutorials curated by Adobe. And then there's quick actions, which is remove background and things like that, with just a click of a button, which is now very popular outside of Adobe as well, which we know like users really want. These are also tied to our intent that you saw on the others on the CCD side. So we're playing around with intent. We're playing around with the most popular content and the most and the most successful content for users. Like we see the completion rates of these tutorials and we use that. So playing around with all of these different things, and there's going to be a series of tests this year to see what's the easiest way and the most successful way to achieve that creative success that I was telling you about when we first started talking. And this is something that we've launched in Photoshop, Illustrator, Premiere Pro. We'll continue to kind of do that across different products. But yeah, this is going to be key. It's a key model for us. And you can get back to this, and you can see in the first screen, there's a little gift icon. It's to show that, hey, you can come back and click on that gift icon to the top right, and you can launch this whenever you want, which wasn't the case before. So we've kind of like repurposed this to be a model that is helpful for you at the tip of your fingers. And also, these are all like deep linked into like specific tutorials, right? So if you go to quick actions, and there you'll see like it says explore the quick actions there, the blue CTA. That opens up you can see this little panel to within that window, what we're calling the discover panel, which allows you to discover all the different types of quick actions that you want to kind of explore. One thing we learned is that we've tried a version where we gave the users suggested quick actions, and users actually preferred exploring. That's one thing I've learned across the board. People just like to explore. So if you suggest it for them, it's less successful than if you get them, point them to the right place for them to explore. And then they do a lot more from there.
Super interesting. I totally would have assumed the opposite.
Yeah,
right? That's the first thing we thought. But then people like to explore. But then if you don't point them in the right direction, they get lost. So
right.
That's the balance between how do you point them to just the right set of things, but give that like the pleasure of exploration.
Yeah, it's such an art and a science. It's not a simple throw up of a modal in any way. I love the concept of quick actions. Like I wish every app could do this, like provide some sort, like I love like your example, like remove the background, you know, I don't know what they are exactly, but like I'm picturing in my head, like crop a, you know, image into a circle, or like any of the common right. things you need to do that I'm doing all the time in these little tools. Like I absolutely love that. And like, what a good way to kind of bite size your way into your product,
exactly.
Especially a product like Photoshop that has just so complicated. Mm. Like, you know, I mean, I'm just like, I used to use Photoshop as a student. And now that I'm an adult, I feel like even more overwhelmed by everything. But it's great because like, it's so powerful. And now there's all these other options. But anyway, I'm rambling. But I just love the idea of, Yeah, quick actions. Like, I want to have that grab cube.
Yeah. Interesting. The other thing I want to mention is around the exploring versus suggested. That's a really interesting insight. It might be that creative cloud users, they're creatives and they like to explore. they're clickers. Like, they're people who just like explore versus maybe like a tool for marketers. Like me and Lila, we probably would have just like, just give me the answer.
Yeah, so, like, that's totally, right. Totally. Like,
is that something you find? Is that a?
It is unique to Adobe. I mean, I think even in the previous companies I've worked at, it has been more give me suggested, you know, content. But you know, if you think of Netflix, right? They give you suggested content, but they still give you enough to explore. I think they've maintained that balance. I think if it's something in the creative field, entertainment field, people don't want to just be pigeonholed into something. They want to be able to explore, but they also want you to know that you understand them. And so we do provide suggestions in different forums. So like, for example, if you open the Photoshop app and you went to the homepage, you'd see a banner there, and there we would suggest specific tutorials. And you know, that's sometimes you suggest it's like a rotating banner. So sometimes you suggest specific tutorials, and then sometimes it'd be like, hey, explore all these quick actions. So we try to maintain a balance there as well, but it's constantly this, what's that balance between direct suggestions and letting a user explore and have fun.